Hello everyone and welcome back to another video, or welcome if you're new. I'm Cora and today I am back with a video where I showcase all of my kids hair CC that I have currently in game. If you enjoyed today's video and you're interested in more CC related videos, make sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, because I upload CC related videos every week and today is a huge one. We're gonna be here for a while. As always in these videos, I'm not gonna put everything in a zip file. I'm gonna say it now because that's against most CC creators TOUs. That's why I do it like that. There's numbers in the video so you can find whatever you like really easy. Links to everything are down below. There's two links, either to my Tumblr or a Google Doc, whichever one you prefer, and you can find everything there. And yeah, as always, we're gonna be here for a hot minute, so get comfy, grab a drink, grab a snack. You know, if it's cold where you are, make sure you drink something warm, get cozied up, and let's just hang out as always in these videos. This one took me forever, as you can imagine. There's like, I think, 189 hairs for kids that I have in game right now. Like, how did I get to this point? I don't know. I also should point out that it's for both male and female kids. I just turned off the little filter up there where you can filter by female or male, so I can see all of the hair and show you all of the kids' hair that I have in game, and I don't have to split it up in like two videos. And yeah, I thought I had little CC for kids, but it turns out I have quite a lot. And I did, before this video, I did go into the game and deleted all of the hairs that I didn't really like or wasn't enjoying anymore, or that didn't look good to me. And I took all of those out, and there's like two things in here that have glitched out, so I just ignore those. Like, I just went past them because I had deleted something, and then I probably didn't delete like the recolor of it or something, so just ignore that. I won't click on them, so it shouldn't bother you unless you check like the little column on the right and see all of the hairs. But with that put aside, let's just talk about life, why don't we? How are you all feeling? I feel like it's been a while since I just talked about my life, but I think it's just been last Friday. And if you listened or if you watched last Friday's video, you will know that our last foster cats, or the first foster cats we ever had, got adopted, and I'm still like heartbroken about it. I thought it would be better by now, but you know, I could still cry if I think about it for too long. It's obviously a good thing, and I keep telling myself like it's good because that way I can rescue more cats, and it's a good thing, you know, like our apartment is free to rescue more cats and get them into loving homes, so it's all good. I'll get there eventually. I bet every start is hard, and I was just very attached to these. I don't know if it was because it's the first foster cats that I had, or if they really did have something special. I mean, they did have something special about them to me, but I don't know if it's like gonna be a reoccurring thing where with all cats I'm gonna be like, oh my god, I love them so much. But yeah, almost a week ago, so on Saturday last week, today is the 14th as I record this, and as you may watch it if you watch it on the day it comes out, but yeah, tomorrow on the 15th, a week ago, we got our new foster cats, and they are like so different to the ones before because we have a cat room. I know, like, so spoiled. We have a whole room for the cats where their litter boxes are in, well, two of them. We have a third in our hallway, and then they get their food there, and there's a lot of stuff for them in there. But we put the first foster cats we got in there for the first few days just so they could settle in and wouldn't always have to be like around us and be scared of us as well as like the new situation. And I've taken that idea from like is he called Jackson Galaxy? I think so. He's done like the show My Cat from Hell, even though he says he doesn't like the title of the show because no cat is from hell, it's the owners that are from hell. Which I agree, because if you have ever watched that show, oh my god, let me know. Like, let's just go on a little like side road here and like walk down this road of the Jackson Galaxy My Cat from Hell until we get back onto the main road. If you've watched any of his videos, he goes into families where people are like, oh my god, my cat is crazy, he's so aggressive, and like, it's usually down to them being idiots. Like, I'm sorry to point it out like that, but if grown people get animals and then don't give the animals like the bare requirements that that type of animal needs to have a happy life, I just, I'm like, I don't know. It blows me away that they're then are like, oh, my cat is aggressive, when they have like this teeny tiny, like, I don't know, baby cat or teenage cat, and it wants to play, and obviously it lashes out if it doesn't have any like activities to do. It's just bored. And they're like, don't play with it. They have like too few litter boxes, which I would understand that if you didn't know that you'd have to have like multiple litter boxes for one cat. But you know, they barely even have like scratch, like things to scratch on, and then they're like complaining that the cat is shredding their sofa. And it's just like, well, dude, you didn't give them anything to scratch on, so like, what do you think they're gonna do? It's a cat. And it's just like the craziest thing. Some of them are obviously like a bit deeper, and I enjoy those the most, where like the cat has like some proper behavioral issues that aren't just down to like the requirements that an animal needs aren't met. You know, sometimes it's like, I don't know, like cats outdoors that it can see through the windows and it's bothered by them, or I don't know, like a behavior that the kids do that you wouldn't instantly like point out if you weren't super knowledgeable about cats. And I think those are like the interesting ones, because obviously now that I'm fostering, I have cats that aren't always going to be super easy, and the first ones had like some behavioral issues, but luckily it was actually really easy, like just by watching certain videos about cats and like learning about it and reading about their behavioral things, it was just very like straightforward what I had to do pretty much. And it's just like so rewarding when you can work with them, and then, you know, like the human cat relationship gets better. It's just very nice to see. And then yeah, let's get back to what I was actually saying though. If you haven't watched that show though, you should. It's kind of I can enjoy it, even though I laugh more about the owners than I am mad about the cats. And I was just talking before though about the cats. They got here, they were very different. Like that room idea where you just have a room for the cat first is like a Jackson Galaxy thing, where they have like a room where they feel safe, and then you swap out like cozy blankets or something from that room into your apartment, so they have like bits in the apartment that smells like them, so they feel a bit more familiar and like it's theirs, like they own that place, rather than just being super shy and like anxious about everything because everything is new and smells new. But with the first two cats, it was way better to do it that way, because they were very skittish and really anxious and quite scared of us as well when they arrived. But with these two, I was like, let's just let them out in the room. We'll lean the door to, so if they feel the need to explore, they can. And we just left them out, and they like instantly explored the whole apartment, one more than the other. But they were like jumping up on everything. One of them was letting us pet him straight away. It's two boys this time. Was letting us pet him straight away. It was just like such a different change. And I think they're just more used to humans being around. I don't know. Or maybe they had like less bad experience with humans in their life, because I noticed with the cats before that they were like scared of hands and everything like that, which was really heartbreaking to see. But these cats are like, they're the most chill cats I've ever seen. Like, they got here, they explored everything. I was like, okay, I'm just gonna leave them, go to bed, because it was quite late when we picked them up. I think it was like 9 p.m. so we actually cooked super late that day, and I think it was good because the kitchen is like the last room in our apartment. Like, there's a big hallway and then the kitchen is right at the end of it, so I think it was good because the cats had like the whole apartment and we were just in that last room, you know, cooking away and doing our own thing. So they just had like every room to explore by themselves without us being there. And it was just very cute because eventually they came into the kitchen and said hi, and one of them let us pet him, and he just enjoyed it so much. I feel like because they have such a long journey, they really just appreciate when they finally arrive somewhere and it's nice, and you know, the people are nice. And the little one, because the little one is only 7 months old, so he's still a kitten, which I thought would be more stressful, but he's very chill, which is surprising. And he jumped into my bed the first night. Like, I slept terrible the first night because they were both in my bed. And the older one, I don't know if it's like a Spanish thing, because they're Spanish cats. If it's a Spanish thing for people to like play with their cats with hands and like let them nibble on your hands, or if it's just the person, because both of these cats were in a different, in the same Spanish foster home before. So I don't know if it's just the woman that likes to do it with them, or if it's like a cultural thing, because like every culture, I feel like interacts with animals differently, and here I've never seen anyone who isn't like completely insane like play with cats with their hand, because it's like such a thin line between being cute and dangerous, because I think 80% of cat bites get infected, and especially if they're that young, I feel like they just get very like riled up when they play, and then they will just misjudge how hard they bite. And if they bite hard, it's going to be very dangerous. So the first night, I'm sorry if you can hear the cat in the litter box. They just had food, so apparently that's what he has to do now. But the first night, the older cat came into my bed and started nibbling on my arm. And I was like, okay, I'm just gonna, you know, see if he's gonna be okay. And he chomped down 2 times and it hurt a little bit. Like, it did hurt, but it wasn't like piercing my skin. And the third one almost pierced my skin. And I was like, yeah, okay, I can't let him do that. So he gets those moments every morning now that he gets in bed and tries to like, he literally reaches out with his arms for my hand and wants to nibble in it. I'm like, no. And I do it 3 or 4 times and then he stops. He's not like super aggressive or fast or anything. He just tries to like sneak his hand up to me and then grab my hand and bite it. But I think he just wants to nibble and he's like excited that someone's awake and he's gonna get fed. But yeah, I don't want him to do that. So if you're from Spain, let me know if you do that with your cats, or if other people you know do that with their cats, because I really don't want them to do it. It's just scary to me that yeah, they could just misjudge it, and because they are so small, they could easily just get too like, you know, hyped up and then bite you. Also, the cat is still in the litter box. I don't know. And then the little one, I don't know if he's not as hyper because he had an accident when he was younger. So they both lived in like a cat colony on the streets, and they found the little one when he was stuck in a fence with one of his paws, and it was really badly infected, and it had started like having worms in it, and they laid eggs in it and all that like nasty stuff. And I think because of that, he might be like a little bit more calm because he can't use his paw that much. Like, they almost couldn't save it, but they did save it. And it looks like very rough because the fur didn't grow back everywhere because there's like scarring going on. And it's not as bad as in the pictures I saw. It definitely looks better, but I think he's still figuring out how much, you know, he can use his paw, because he uses it to play, which I think he does because then he can stand on like his healthy paw and use his other paw to play with. But he does not walk like perfectly fine. He always lays down as well, which I don't know if it's just because he's a kitten or because he's more chill than other cats, but when they're both in the kitchen and I'm doing something, he lays down instantly. So it might be more exhausting to him to like stand on that paw, so he always just lays down. But other than that, like, he plays normally, he runs around, like, he's fine as far as I can tell. And obviously the vets in Spain did have a look at it, so he should be fine. And I don't know if that is why he's a bit more calm, but they're also really cute because when I sit on my desk, and I like, it's bad, but I sit on my desk like most of the time because I work on my desk, and then I also do uni from home, so I sit on my desk when I do uni, and then I also game as a hobby, so, you know, like, everything I do is on my PC sitting down. don't come for me, please. But when they come into my lap, it's really cute because the bigger one sat in my lap like the first night, and I was like, okay, well, cool. And then he gets really jealous. Not so much now, but the first few days he got really jealous. So when I stroked the little one, he would always like come over and be like, no, me, 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 and like barge in and like put his head between me and the little one. You know, he's very jealous. The little one is really chill though. Like, he doesn't care. He's such a calm cat. He's totally fine with like everything. Such a like laid back cat. I don't know. Both of them are really. But it was funny because when the little one first got into my lap, the other one was sitting on the cat tree near the window in my room, and he saw it and he was like, nah. So he came over and just rushed onto my lap and literally sat on his face, like on the kitten's face. And they do it all the time now. Like, I don't know, I always sit on my desk chair with my legs crossed. I don't know if anyone else does that, but to me it's more comfortable usually. I do change how I sit occasionally when I can't feel my legs anymore from sitting like that, but that's like my preferred way to sit down on my desk, is like with my legs crossed. And they both just lay on my lap now, and I just think that's so cute and like funny because I've never seen that before. I don't know, if you have cats, let me know what they do and if they like to sit on your lap together as one. They also curl up with each other quite a lot, which is really cute. And it's exciting to see how they change every day, because obviously they're still like a bit skittish. When I get up and walk around, they're like a bit nervous, and when the doorbell goes, stuff like that. But I think they're gonna get used to it really fast, because they're just such confident cats. It's like such a big difference to the ones before. It's crazy. But I don't know. It's just a new experience, I guess. And I thought that I would be less sad about the other ones going, because there's like new cats and I have a task and everything. And I guess to an extent that's true, but I'm still very sad. And I shall keep you updated, you know. You can be part of my sadness. That's okay. And I really hope you guys care about cats, because if you don't, then all of my last videos would have been like torture to you. I'm sorry if you're not interested in that, but that's my life right now, you know. That's pretty much what I do right now, apart from uni, and uni is very boring, let me tell you. Oh my god, I have an exam in like a month and a few days, and I haven't done enough because it's so boring. So I have like a lot to catch up on, but I also don't want to catch up on it because it's so boring. It's like this semester I'm doing statistics, which in itself, it might sound crazy, but I like statistics. I like math, at least like basic math. I went to uni for math and I hated that, but like basic math, you know, like calculating things, that type of stuff. I like that. I enjoy that. But we also, with doing statistics, we have to learn this program called R, and it's like a statistics kind of programming program. Wow, genius. And it's just very boring. I don't know. I don't know if it's boring in itself or if I just get frustrated, because if you just learn different ways to like code, what is it? Is it even considered coding? I don't know. But if you learn different commands, it's just, I feel like I didn't really learn anything. Like, I like to feel like I actually learned something, and when someone asks me like, oh, what did you do today, I could be like, oh, I learned about this and that, and then I could tell them. But for me, it's just like random commands, and I'm like, well, yeah, I don't know them by heart, you know. I could look at my like document and I could tell you what it does and I can use it, but I don't know it all by heart. Like, it's just weird. And yeah, I don't know, have you ever learned anything like that, and how did it feel for you? But anyways, after all of my babbling, this video was over faster than I thought. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what your favorite hairstyle was. Mine are like the last few ones. There's some really cute ones at the end here. And with that said, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, please don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already, and I will see you all next time. Bye.